at the gates of Hades. You remember the city gates? You see the point here? So at the gates of Hades, you had a temple that symbolized the most powerful, brutal force that they could think of, that all Jews, more or less, you know, were afraid of, and that was the Roman army. That could kill them at any point of time. Right? So, let's now look at the text. Once again, what does Jesus say? He says like this, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. Now, we've already covered the Hades and the gates. A symbol for Hades and a symbol for what's at the gates. Are you with me? Now we come to the church. Now, this is the first time Jesus mentions the church, the Christian church. And he says something encouraging, right? That the gates of Hades, the Roman Empire, will not overcome it. Are you happy for that?
Amen.
And that is all because of the book of Revelation, chapter 5, verse 5, and John sees into heaven and says that the lion of the tribe of Judah has conquered. He's already won the victory, right?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
So, what is the first word for the church? The first word is a Greek word here, used for the church. And anyone know? Yeah, you know, with all of you. Ecclesia. And what does it mean? Yeah. Assembly goes to the Hebrew
word. I don't remember that we were up here.
Good. But the Greek word means really something else. Or an addition at least to it.
Thank you.
Ecclesia means, if you translate it directly from the Greek to the English, it's two words put together to one word. Kali or Ecclesia means those who are called. Ek means out. So Jesus' first description of the church says, the church are those who are called out. You start to see the point now? He says that he has come to call people out from the kingdom of death. He's stronger than the powers at the gates, the Roman Empire, and any empire throughout world history. And he has come to bring mankind, anyone who wants to take his wounded hand, to let him lead him out from the kingdom of death. And that makes the church the kingdom of life. You start to get the picture here? And this is exactly the moment when Jesus starts to say, how is this all going to come about? Well, that is, you know, he might be standing right here and he starts to teach them about what? What did I read to you at the end of the text? From that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things. He started to talk about him dying and being resurrected from the dead. Right? So what he's telling them right here is that the way I'm going to pull this all about is that I'm going in. I'm going in. I'm going, you know, way in. I'm going to the most dark place of them all. He's going to be in Gethsemane. He's going to drink in all of mankind's sin into his body. That's why he has anguish, so he sweats blood in Gethsemane. It's not because of the nails. It's because him becoming the perfect atoning sacrifice for all of mankind's sin. He's going in, man, to the most dark place here. You see? And the key is the cross. He's doing it because of love. It's love. Okay. Not this, you know, it's love. The way of love. And then he starts, you can read the rest of the text yourself. Then he starts to teach about the cross. Us having a calling to, you know, walk the way of the cross. And the message he gives them here is that he has already won the victory. He will die on the cross, he will go way in, he will bring people out to the kingdom of life, he will crush that, and the gates of Hades will never prevail over the Christian church.
Amen. Amen. That's good.